Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the Deathmarch difficulty. I would kinda say we're playing Blood and Wine in this episode, cause, well, if you saw the previous episode, High Stakes, we bumped into a familiar character. And that played out like this. What's this? Is it? Oh, wow! Okay, never mind, I'm gonna keep this for later. So yeah, we bumped into Vivian over there next to the water, looking at a lot of birds for some reason, so that's very fitting. So let's see what she has to say. Hello, Vivian.
Vivian, hey.
She's still alive.
Yeah. So good to see you.
Well, good to see you too. How are you?
How do you feel? No relapse?
None. I feel wonderful. You've no idea how relieved I am. I went to see a mama's play in Pont Vanis, out of doors, and I went on late into the night, and I did not need to flee at dusk. I also attended Baroness Dickledale's ball, danced to the break of dawn.
I wonder if both her and Guillaume are here when you get them together. Kind of wondering that now. Could be a what-if episode. Because we kind of know what happened to Guillaume in this turn of events. Because he got himself a bit drunk and passed out in Beauclair. So, in Novigrad, what are you doing here?
What's brought you to Novigrad?
I've toured the entire city already. Now I seek a ship to take me to the Skellige Isles. I've heard there are beautiful flying sirens there. And mountains that rise out of the sea into the sky. Is any of it true?
It all is, actually. Except you'll want to watch out for the sirens. As beautiful as they are dangerous.
I shall be careful, I promise.
Because they can kill you.
Farewell, Geralt. One last thing. I would like you to have this. I kept it at first...
Oh, a feather!
...as a memento. But I think I'd prefer not to have anything to remind me of that time. Will you take it?
Of course.
Of course we will.
Thank you.
Feather from Vivian. Take care. This sounds kind of dirty. Was that a wink? I saw a wink. Can we replay that? That was a wink. I saw her wink at me. Vivian, you want to have some fun time? Some man on bird? Never mind, I'm going to shut up. Let's see what else we can do in Novigrad, because I think we still have one more quest available in Novigrad. Never mind, just check the map. It's not in Novigrad, it's on the Vagelbutt Estate. So I'll see you guys there in a minute. So we're at the Vagelbutt Estate, and it seems like...
Dumbstruck with awe, behold, madly galloping poetry.
We have another race master. Oh, that's probably to compete in the horse races then, I suppose.
Wondering if I could take part in the races.
If you've coin for the rider's fee and a steed of your own, why not? Decide quickly, please. There's a race about to begin.
Well, you know what? Now that we're here, here's my entrance fee. I want a race.
I want a race.
Grand, your name and a name of your steed.
Geralt.
Geralt, please. Please.
Excellent. Your opponent.
Pronounce that correctly.
Seamus Holt astride Athos.
Okay.
Competitors, saddle up!
On a race, three, the great Erasmus Vagelbutt. Memorial Derby!
Off you go!
No. Nope, goodbye.
Hide the wenches, witch is coming!
I always like the music during the horse races. They're so soothing. Like you're out on a lovely stroll, not in a neck-breaking race for some reason. So yeah, this is not gonna take long. Because, yeah, I've got pretty much everything decked out on Roach, so, fastest horse in this side of the world. It seems like we're almost around the track already, so that won't be an issue. So, yeah, there's the finish, I think. The large tent right next to the estate. Ooh, I'm going to be barely having enough stamina for that. There we go. Okay.
The final of the Erasmus Vagelbutt
Jesus Christ.
Memorial Derby is over.
Oh, that was the final already.
Is Geralt...
Not bad. Yet we shouldn't kid ourselves. The competition was hardly stiff. Shall I sign you up for another?
Wait. How does this actually work? Because there's... It appears like there's nothing new about this apart from that, so... Maybe later. Talk to the Master of Ceremonies to begin the race.
Raises taxes, of course.
Huh, seems like this stays an active quest for some reason. I might have to do that in between recordings just to finish that up. Because that's not so interesting to watch, because it's going to be the same track all over again. So let's head to Skellige. I still have a few side quests left in Skellige, so see you guys right over there. So we're at Enskellig at the Uriala Harbor. I think that's the northeastern most tip of the map. And there seems to be someone in need here. Is this Skellige woman? Okay, sheep, take it easy. Hello, Skellige woman.
Couldn't help overhearing your conversation. Trial of the path. What is it?
A trial of the path.
On Skellige tradition, young men must complete the path. Only then do they turn true warriors.
So what's this path like?
Old Gunnar can tell you all you want to know about the path of warriors. He's the one leads the ritual. Lives at the foot of Mount Ardaclove.
Are those two... They have the same face, right? Those are sisters then, okay. Okay, never mind. Talk to the man who oversees the path. The path of a true warrior. Well, I am a true warrior, so why not... pass that test really quickly. So that's the arena, I think, where we fought the bear. The final challenge in the fisticuff fights. Trail to Ingvar's Fang. I think I already did this part, because I had to do that for one of the gear episodes. Okay, hello, Gunnar.
I don't know you. You don't know me. So what's your problem?
These isles were ours alone once. No foreigner dared set foot here. And if they did, they'd not return home. The good days, those.
Definitely not for those unlucky enough to land here. You, Gunnar?
Who's asking? And why?
I want to travel the path of warriors.
And my name is Geralt.
But if you've had your fill of life, go on, try.
What do I do?
Path's got two offshoots. One leads into mountain peaks, the other into the bowels of the earth. Traverse both, and you'll have proved your valor.
Okay then, tell me all about it.
Tell me about the mountain path.
It leads along the crest of Mount Ardaclove. You'll find a crimson shawl at the peak. Bring that back as proof you've reached the
path.
And
a dead guy over there.
Doesn't sound like much of a challenge.
Clear you've not spent much time in our mountains.
We did, actually. We did spend a lot of time in the mountains, so want to hear about the path that leads underground.
Can you tell me more about the underground path? Is a cave of some sort?
Aye, but the corridors leading to it are flooded. No Continentals ever managed to swim them. Takes training since youth, a lot of diving after pearls.
We'll see about that. What else?
At the cavern's end, a surprise awaits. Take what you find there, bring it to me.
A surprise? What kind?
You'll see. So long as you get to the end. So long as the harpies don't get you.
The harpy's in a cave. Okay, then I want to try.
Well, I'm not scared to try.
Not just foreign, but dumb too. Well, no cure in that. Well, run to the top of Mount Ardaclove. Grab the crimson shawl. Then reach the cave. At its end, you'll find something I'm not about to describe. On you go then. Show the world what you're worth.
Okay then, mystery man Gunnar.
This blade's not worth shite.
Let's check the... it does look kind of different, but I thought I've been to the top over there, and that apparently bumped me up to level 50. There seems to be blood down there as well, so descend down to the cave entrance. Okay. It sends me somewhere else for some reason. Why? No. I'm going to take the path. Of course, I'm going to take the path. And here we go. And jump. That's no biggie. And jump! That's no biggie at all. Few dead guys. With a lot of money. Thank you. Don't see a crimson shawl yet, so let's get higher. It's taking me higher. Those sirens are a bit disconcerting, but... Oh, and now I can't... Well, what the... Goodbye. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay, kind of saw that coming, but Geralt tries to... Oh, for... Jesus fucking Christ, Geralt. Just to explain this a little bit, when you go into combat mode, you can't jump anymore. So, unless I defeat every stupid flying thing around here, I'm forbidden to fucking jump. Gonna just try and get there, at least. I'm kind of protected in here, so if I just slash the multi pieces over here, that should be fine. And in two. Guess I'm giving that Scaliger a good laugh, though. So. There we go. That's one jump. Yeah, good riddance to you, sir. Woman. There we go. Another siren down. I think she lost her head there. Give me all that loot. And looks like I just need to continue jumping. Just need to be careful not to slip on anything. There we go. Going up seems easy enough. Now, I think this is the part I did already. Yeah. Okay, so I came from down there for some reason and not... Oh, interesting. So let's just slide ourselves down and follow this path. There we go. So this is where we found one of the diagrams, I think. I think it was even the bear skull gear in there. But let's see if we can't get any higher. Okay, there we go. I could have fast traveled because I have the marker over there already, but what's the fun in that, eh? So now we're on the higher path using this thing. Let's go even higher, and I think we're almost at the top. I think there's a few more jumps. Easy enough. Oh, that's... Wait a second. Were you here with the previous...
The white-haired one goes to his...
Time?
Nay, no foreigner can traverse the path of warriors.
I think I... Found this shack? Yeah, because I looted everything. But this man wasn't there. So let's jump again. Up, up and away. Then across. Oh shit, he found another monster, didn't he? He just pulled out his sword randomly. There we go, and of course there's another one. Put that away, yeah. There we go. And I can eat, oh, for fuck's sake, Geralt. Pull that sword by your ass, thank you. Calm down. Climb back up. And jump. Okay. There we go.
Place of power.
And there's the harpy. Okay, so now you can kill it. Now you have my permission to kill it. So we're at the top now, but I don't see the shawl that we needed to bring. Yeah, get over here. There we go. So I think there was a bit of loot in that thing, but let's just draw from this thing as well now that we're here. Not that it will do us that much good, but it's something at least. So now, let's descend down to the cave, and I think, didn't we need to find a freaking shawl? I don't see the shawl. Never mind, I have the fast travel point if I need to. So let's go down. And slide. Slide. I think this is a very good spot to get the Rad's Tease Bro trophy from, I think, Hearts of Stone, where you need to slide down a hill for 10 seconds uninterrupted. Okay, that does seem a bit deep. Hello. Travel through the tunnel and collect proof you made it to the end. Seems easy enough. Empty bottles and... I think I'm gonna go for a killer whale potion. Just so we could stay underwater a bit longer. I think that's that dirty orange stuff here. Yeah, consume. There we go. And let's dive down. Geralt is grey now for some reason. And my Witcher senses don't work as good anymore, but that, I think, always happens. So I think I see a chest over there. So let's check that out. Ruby dust. Nothing of interest, but let's hurry it up a bit. Because it's supposed to be hard, remember? It's supposed to be hard to get through this cave. Oh, what's this? It's red and it's shiny. Path of Warriors completion token. Okay then. I thought there was something at the end. Jeez, it's dark in here. Okay, so here we can get out. So now that we have the completion token, it should be straightforward. And that's because he was being so mysterious about everything. Was something at the end of the cave? Something he wasn't going to describe? Was it a token? You couldn't describe a token? Oh, shit. I think I'm going to go for cat. Superior cat. There we go. Okay, so now we need to jump across over here. There we go. Anything else hidden around here? Doesn't seem like there is. And then we can get out, I think. Hello? Oh, this keeps going, doesn't it? Oh, now we're outside and there's a bandit outside. But first, let's take a white honey to clear everything up. And there we go. Climb up and let's kill that lovely bandit over there. Hello, sir. Let's keep the Quen sign up.
You're dead! Ready.
And that was the What Was That trophy. I saw I was missing that, so I did a counter, an attack, a sign, and a bomb all within 4 seconds. So that was lovely, lovely, lovely. Thank you for that trophy. So let's find our way back to Gunnar and see what he can tell us about the path any further. So hello, Gunnar. Can you, do we have a... Seriously? Wow. You're a big bear, aren't you? I'm a bit overleveled for this though, so there we go. Down goes the bear. Thank you very much. White bear hide. Never seen actually one that's so big. That was awesome. Hello, Gunnar.
You bring news?
Yeah, I just saved you from the bear.
But I managed to get to the end. Here's proof.
First Outlander to complete the trial. A feat worthy of respect. I'll make sure news of your deeds spreads across the Five Isles.
Okay, you're welcome. I do think it's funny that it's called the Path of Warriors, but when you start the quest, it sends you all the way to the back to get to the cave way easier than going up the mountain. But that wouldn't have been a nice video now, wouldn't it? So, with that done, I'm going to take a little break, so thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really, really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.